child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Uh-oh, I think there we are. Yep, there's a sign. Woo! Welcome to Massachusetts. Well, I already did Massachusetts. So I guess that means we're coming into Vermont. Oh man, I'm excited. Welcome to Vermont. That's great. Oh, that's so awesome. And then we're starting the long trail as well. I'm trying to keep it on there so y'all can read it. That's really neat. Hey, hey. Try and get a selfie in front of it. I haven't used my sticker in forever. So, at least this will be one for my video. Vermont, something I've been waiting for so long. So, without further ado, as I always have done, Massachusetts, Vermont, starting the big three. Hey guys, so I'm up on top of Glastonbury Mountain on the lookout tower up here, and I've got some pretty incredible views. As you can see, I'm gonna try and take you around because I've got a full 360. It's really awesome. Sorry the bars and whatnot, but it's pretty sweet. I think that's where we're gonna be heading tomorrow. I don't remember the name of the mountain, but it's a really famous one. It's one of the ones that it's the one that Benton McKay envisioned the AT on. So whatever that is, I don't remember the name of it, but pretty sure that's where we're heading tomorrow. And then all kinds of beautiful views. This way is my favorite, so I'm gonna take you out over the window. This is incredible. It's cool, you can see the shadow on the trees. Maybe you see my hand moving. Ah, you can't, you can see me waving. Pretty cool though. It's really beautiful. I'm gonna just stay up here for a while. I did about 22 miles today. I have no idea where Clean Skittle is. It was the first day I've out hiked him. I'm sure he'll show up later, but doing like 19 tomorrow. I should probably be slowing down, but it is what it is. Vermont is absolutely beautiful so far. Just can't get enough of these views. So this is my tent site for the night. Decided to make another video before I go to bed. As you can see, there's the fire tower that I was on not too long ago. It's June 23rd, by the way. That's really the only reason I decided to make this video. Tell you what day it is. So also show off my cool spot. Got a couple other thru hikers back there. Hootie from Mississippi, on a solo. A bunch of cool people. Still don't know where Skittle is. Hope he catches up tomorrow. We'll have to see.
Echo I got was in Virginia. I don't remember where it was, but I remember where it was. I had a rhythm.
It's windy.
I thought you were dodging his video.
That too.
Is it a video?
Yeah, it's a video. Hey guys, so I just stopped in for a little morning snack at Kid Gore Shelter. And this is the view right out of the front of the shelter. It's really pretty. Oh, as you can see, the sun's probably making a pretty bad glare, but you still get the view in there. And then this is the shelter. Got some bunks and there's a table. They've been doing this table system like in the shelter. They just extend the bottom bunks out and have a have a table in the middle, which is pretty neat. I like it. But yeah, it is the 24th of June. I'm about 4 miles into the day. I'm about to go down into the little valley down there and then up that mountain you see on the left side of the screen. And it's pretty easy from there, actually. It's flat for a while until we go up Stratton Mountain. That's the name of the mountain that I couldn't remember last night, which is like a 2,000-foot climb, but it looks pretty gradual. I don't think I'm really worried about it. And then it's downhill from there, so it's going to be a nice day.
So this is what you have to look forward to in Vermont. I've seen this a lot lately. Hey guys, so I'm just climbing up Stratton Mountain here. It's a really, really pretty climb. Pretty easy climb too. I haven't had to brake once. It's been really gradual. And if it's steep in parts, it'll level out shortly so that you can catch your breath. It's really an easy climb. But yeah, it's really beautiful. I just wanted to show you what the trail was looking like. It kind of reminds me of the Smokies. Just a little bit more rocky, and these pine trees are more frequent, but still it's really, really nice. I don't know how far away I am from the summit, but I know it's at 3,900 feet, so it's the first time we've been up that high in a long time, so I'm pretty excited. I will check back in at the top.
So this is my view from the fire tower on top of Stratton Mountain. It's pretty awesome. I like that lake. I'm pretty sure we were on that mountain last night. I think that's Glastonbury. And then it's cool way in the background. You can see that tall one back there. I'm pretty sure that's Greylock, because we saw it last night, but I didn't mention it in the video. But pretty sure that's Greylock. That is Glastonbury, because I can see a tower on top. Although a lot of these have towers, but still. Got a beautiful view. Awesome. Loving it.
Hey guys, I don't know if you can read the sign. But I'm at Stratton Pond, 3 miles down from Stratton Mountain. It's a really beautiful lake. The shelter's not far behind me, but there were a couple people there. So I decided I'm gonna go on and
try and find a stealth spot, maybe somewhere around this pond. If not, there's a few streams. Listed on the
guidebook not far ahead, so I'll see where I get. It gets me a little closer to town tomorrow anyway.
I'm gonna pull a short day tomorrow and do like 13 or so to the top of Bromley Mountain, so it'll be pretty sweet.
Man, I'd love to stay here and fish.
If I find a campsite, I just might.
But yeah, that's the plan. So this is camp tonight.
Still on the 24th of June. You can see the trail behind my tent, or actually in front of my tent. There's a bridge that I crossed over, and I'm just stealth camping right here all alone. It's pretty nice. But I just wanted to talk about hiker hunger for a second. I didn't really ever get it that bad. I was never just hungry all the time. Up until now, I guess. I literally have no food left. Except for this one oatmeal packet, and it's getting killed now. Never done this before, but I've seen people just add water to the packets, and it's not leaking or anything, and it's hydrating. So I guess we'll see how that goes. I've rationed three granola bars for tomorrow and my breakfast, which is just a oatmeal shake, to get me 9 miles into town. So I think I'm pretty much going to be starving by the time I get there, but we'll just have to see.